If you have ever heard of time lapse or slow motion, these are things that you can use in your filming, in the camera stuff, but you can also do it afterwards in Filmora. And I edit the clip of the motorway here. In the clip, if I right click on it, I can choose speed and duration. And I also have that an icon in the toolbar for speed. I'll first click right on the clip and choose speed and duration, and it will give me this opportunity. I can just drag the slider up and down. So let's say that I want to make it, the default value was 1, so let's make it twice. I want to play it twice as fast. And if I click OK, then you will see that in the timeline, the length of the video is divided because it's 2 times as fast as it was. That means that if I make it even more fast, so like a time lapse, I say it's 20 times faster than it normally was. The original clip was around 1 minute long and it ended around here. And right now it's only a few seconds long because it's played 20 times faster. That means that if I play it, you have to pay attention. It will be gone before you know it. Boop. There it is. A few seconds are left of the minute that I had originally. And I'll press undo twice. Then I have my original clip back. The same goes for slower. And let's do that with the icon here. The icon makes it a lot The icon gives you some preset values. You can make it slower by these presets. You can make it faster, or you can reverse it to normal. But I want to make it slower this time. Let's say that I want to play it at half the speed or maybe even a quarter of the speed. That means that the video gets longer instead of 1 minute. I'll slide it to the right. The end is now probably around 4 minutes. Yes, exactly. Because I said play it at a quarter of the speed. If I hit play now, in the preview window, you will see a pretty slow traffic there. And you can do that with any video that you want. I'll press undo again and get it back to the original size. What I need to show you is in this pop-up window, I'll get back to the reverse speed in a minute, but I want to show you what this one does, the ripple edit. Let's say that I have a clip behind it. If I play this clip twice the speed as the original one, that means that the length of the video is reduced to around 30 seconds. What do you want to happen with the gap? Because if this one gets shorter, this part will be empty. Well, that's what Filmora asks you with these options. Do you want ripple edit or not? If I don't check it and I click OK and I say OK twice the speed, sorry, I want to type 2. The duration is 30 seconds. I click OK and then it will leave the gap. But if I undo that, if I choose ripple delete, ripple edit, and I click OK, then automatically, sorry, I don't know why it doesn't do that. Ripple edit. Ah, I have to type in 2, of course. I did undo it. There we go. And now the clip is half the size. And the clip behind it and everything that was behind that, if that was the case, will automatically move to the left and leave no gaps anymore. So I'll remove this clip. I'll remove the last clip. And I'll get this back to normal speed again. Normal, then it becomes 1 minute. And the last thing that I wanted to show you about this speed button is that you can also choose for reverse. And the only thing that that does is play your video backwards. And in some cases that can look funny. And I also saw certain videos with drone material where if you play it backwards, it really looks like the image is filmed in a different way. Like if you film with your drone and it's flying away from you, or whatever you film, if you play it backwards, you get a completely different effect. Is it flying towards something or flying away? You don't have to shoot that footage twice. You can just use it the other way around. And with the traffic, it's the same. Are they driving backwards or are they driving forwards?